Now, folks, if y'all are in for some intense emotional experiences and would like to experience this for yourself, please call us at 713-807-1794, where I will come and murder your family members in a new service I'm calling Johnny Window Pains, Grieving Pains. That's right. I will murder your family, you will be upset, and you will experience the most intense emotional pain you've ever seen in your life. That's right. Johnny Window Pains, Grieving Pains. 713-807-1794. Call now.
Gregory's not the only one that's gonna die tonight. We're gonna kill off a lot of characters from this season. I might be the judge, I don't know. Today this episode is the last episode of the season, so it's perfect timing, actually. Let's bring out who we had today. Who do we got? We got Leap Dog. We got AT and Bree. We got Bobby. We got Paper Piper. Tom Waits. Prison Librarian. Bonafide. Smokey. Couch. Couch might die today. House cat. We're gonna have to kill a bunch of people today. It's mostly because of our budget. And also the noise. We want it quiet in here. That's my judgment. Even that is too loud. So let's put it back in the box to make it quiet. That's all you're gonna get. So, let's bring on the death kids later. Who else died? I mean, well, it's only right, you know. Prince died. Who else died? Okay. Who else died? Blowfly died. Clarence. He died. You know Clarence? Blowfly? Well, he's dead now, so. Is there already there are people crying back there already? All right. We also have Sleuth coming in to slay. I like the alliteration there. But they're gonna. What kind of music are they? Anybody know?
Alt rock.
Alt rock? For like from the 90s?
Yeah!
Okay. 90s are dead. But Sleuth brought them back. We're gonna bring them back. Tonight. Sleuth. Bringing back the 90s. And maybe that's a clue that some of the characters that die off tonight will come back. Let's see if there's any hope for that. I'll be the judge of that, though. So, bring out Sleuth. Whenever you're ready.
No, we're not
I'll wait until they're ready. Should we go to a bumper?
We have to.
All right.
We're supposed to.
If you want, go ahead. Bring out the death sentenced. We got the fortune teller. Let's see if she knows she's gonna die. We got Christopher Gregory. We got, he'll come out later. We got Leap Dog. And right at his tails, we got House Cat. And we also got Bobby. No? All right, well, I'll be the judge of that. And we got, who are you?
AT and Bree.
Right here. CEO, AT Bree, CEO. Or was it Bree TA?
You be the judge of that.
I'll be the judge of that. And, there's the house cat. Man, so did you know that you were gonna be on tonight?
Oh, I knew. I knew, and I know many, many things.
Yeah.
That is part of my blessing. One of the things that I try to keep just really evident with all of my clients and all of the people and the souls that I work with and work for, mm-hmm. is that, you know, the universe knows all, but each of us is just a vessel. We can't know everything. We cannot know all the things. I am personally blessed with the gift of sight.
Oh, I have those eyes too.
Yes, and it's a beautiful, beautiful blessing. And I don't always know what's going to happen, but when I know, oh, do I know.
Yeah. Can you predict who you think are, well, I mean, who you know will die? Who, tell us who you, what's going on. Who's dying tonight?
Well, darling,
I'll be the judge of that.
We are all dying and we are all dead.
Oh, that's true.
In the cosmic sense, we are all born and we are all dead. So we are all simultaneously all the things because, you know, what is time but an artificial construct of the imagined mind?
Do we have a clock?
Yep.
To demonstrate what she's talking about? Can we have a watch?
But on your point of death, I feel, honestly, again, being non-existential in this particular moment, there is a lot of weight in the room. There's a lot of weight in the room, and I usually find that this means that there are big things to come.
Oh.
Beginnings and ends, climaxes, and reservoirs. Big life moments.
Okay.
You can definitely predict that, absolutely.
All right. Well, I can't judge that.
Also, he's gonna die.
Okay. Leap Dog.
Today.
Will you come back next year, Leap Dog?
No, I couldn't come back next year because, as you know, I only come back on Leap Day.
Leap years, yes.
Leap days of the leap year. So
when's that?
Next one should be 2020, I think?
4 years from now, yes.
4 years from now, almost. A little less.
Who decides that?
I don't know. I'm just a dog. I don't have any really concept of time other than the brief explanation of why I only show up once a day every 4 years. One day every 4 years.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Honestly, it's kind of tiring. I'm sick of explaining the premise. It's kind of a stupid holiday. And as a dog, I don't really have any kind of understanding of human time.
I can tell you that most people that celebrate it are born on that day, and they're incredibly inconvenienced by it. Yeah, because, you know, like a 20-year-old is only 4 legally.
Yeah. I don't like that.
Yeah.
But I'm tired of doing it. I'm tired of showing up every 4 years. I'd rather die than live a life one day at a time every 4 years.
Mm-hmm.
And who are we to not accommodate his wish, his willful life?
No, so yeah. Please kill me. Please judge me unfit to live. You want me to just handle it?
Sure.
I'm gonna table this. Okay. I'm gonna table this discussion for later.
Okay.
Let's move on. We have other people to talk to.
Yeah. We got the CEO of
What do you want to know?
Is that AT&Brie?
Did you have any products worth
a very salacious company, for the record?
The last time you all saw me, I was a different person then, and now...
Why is that?
You know, I've just got...
Did you change hats?
Got a new feng shui happening. Yes. You know, I'm an adventure seeker.
So. This day and age, I feel like people that say that they're an adventurer should just get slapped in the face.
It's right here.
Well, I don't want to venture that far.
That's what I thought.
So,
I'm sensing some real tension here. I really don't think it takes.
Large corporations have always been contentious.
I told you I'm a new person.
How so?
You know, I've...
Besides the hat.
I've lifted stricken family out of poverty.
I feel like we're mediating a personal relationship here right now.
I'll personally be the judge of that.
I don't want to know this guy on a personal level.
And, there is, you know, Sleep is halfway dead. Is somebody asleep over there?
I think I woke her.
Wake her up so we can kill her.
Have you not met her yet?
No.
Oh man, she's always hanging around. This is our house cat.
Yeah, she's always here,
she's
apparently.
She's literally always here.
Every 4 years I see her. Every 4 years for a day, and she's horrible. I hate her the most.
She's the best house cat.
I hate you. I don't like 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 you. I don't understand you. I don't understand you. I don't understand you. I don't.
Hey. I'm pretty sure there's a squirrel over my left shoulder. There's a squirrel.
Squirrel. Squirrel. I'm bigger than you.
I have too much money for
this. I'm bigger than you. I'm bigger.
Where are the squirrels?
I'm bigger than you.
Okay.
Why am I here?
Works every time.
I've already bought my death.
Yeah? Death by, what? Death by fake
save
gun?
My soul for freedom.
Have you never met the house cat? You should definitely meet the house cat. She is very grumpy once awoken.
Oh.
But she is, I would say a fixture within our little community.
Yeah? You find her at, a hardware store?
Only if there's a cozy nook. There's a cozy nook, you can probably find her there, yeah.
Uh-huh.
It's usually the only rule of thumb when trying to locate the house cat. Is there or is there not a cozy nook, yay or nay?
I don't know.
No. You can see she's enjoying her own little cozy nook.
Yeah.
Her own little cozy nook right now.
I see that. I can't judge that.
No, it's pretty unjudgeable. That's why we love the house cat. That's why she's been our mascot.
Tell us
for so long. Yeah.
Tell us, so Leap Dog, you're only here once every 4 years.
Mm-hmm.
So there's really no reason to keep you around.
No, none whatsoever.
So we can't kill you.
You can.
Okay, we'll do that, and then let's do it. And you have any last words? How about?
A holiday only celebrated once every 4 years because of a weird thing with the calendar is stupid.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And why don't you are you a music fan?
Just
with
you
your
know,
advanced
like,
hearing?
I feel like this is a little bit too bloody. Will you please just
Yeah, somebody gave me this. I don't think that's the way people should die.
I am a music fan. Would you like me to introduce the band before you have me?
Yeah.
Can we just make this easy?
I'm escorted off the mortal plane.
Tell him.
Ladies and gentlemen! They regaled us once before with awesome alt-rock tunes from the 90s, which, as we mentioned, are dead. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage and the show one more time, Sleuth!
This song is by Primal Scream and it's called Velocity Girl.
Here she comes again with vodka in her veins. Been playing with the spike. She couldn't get it right. Splendor and silver dress. Velocity possessed. The world was hers again. And it fell apart again. I don't need anyone to hurt me. No, not anyone at all. Because my so-called friends have let me in. I don't care at all. Leave me alone. Leave me alone. Leave me alone.
Sir. All right, you'll get your turn.
It's a theoretical couch.
Yeah, just open your mind, man. Open your heart and your mind today, okay? Can I just ask, like two things? Open your heart and your mind. Thank you. So welcome to the Couch and Kelly with Sleuth. This guy, we're about to fist fight across this amazing existential couching experience. I'm gonna keep calling it a couch. So you guys, Sleuth is, this is not their first time on, and hopefully will not be their last time on. This is actually one of my favorite bands that we've had on.
Thank you.
Yeah, really, really cool group of dudes. Always have a really fun time, like in studio, professionally, and also with the interviews. So let's get really super weird with it. Have I pitted you guys against each other yet?
Yeah, I think you did last time.
Then that didn't work, right? Yeah. Does anyone want to throw anyone else under the bus tonight?
Well,
great story.
Two of us forgot things, so
let's
we
get
did
real
it to ourselves.
Yeah, he forgot the guitar.
Yeah,
he forgot his drum throne.
Hopefully he went back
home.
Drummers need stools.
They're called drones, man.
Not stools. Stools.
What are they called?
Stools.
Drones.
Thrones?
They're called drum thrones.
Is that real?
King
or is
of the
being
beat.
Fabulous right now?
It's king of the beat. It's the drummer.
Stool.
You know what, you guys? Okay, so is this common? Is like the drummer like the diva of the group? Is that like typical?
Yeah,
or is this just unique to your situation?
I mean,
right, look at those shades. He's clearly the diva of the group.
Yeah, right now he's definitely the diva of the group.
Can you see through his body with his t-shirt?
Where is this? You know what's funny? That's funny that you're asking
screen,
that.
Like in...
No, yeah, it looks like it's... Yeah, it is presenting. It's presenting as black. Yeah, all your green is presenting is the same as our background color.
Yeah.
Funny story. So the ends of my hair are that color green, and usually it presents as the green screen and, like, picks up. Right now, the tone, I think I toned it down so it's not picking up. But for a solid couple of weeks, anytime I had my hair down, it was like my chin and then my green hair. So it was like, it just filled in the background information under my head, and I was just a floating head. Anytime I was trying to do like serious skits. If you ever, you guys have been on the show a couple times. Okay, listen, just go with me. Just go with me. If you guys have been on the show, you know we have a series of hand motions, right?
No.
To like signal. You've ever seen like a group of people being like,
I thought y'all were flirting.
Or like, okay, so this is the one that I get. Okay, this is the one that I get. And I was like, what does this mean? What does that mean? It means move your hair out of the way because you're a disembodied head right now. And you're screwing up the scene. The serious theatrical scene. God, Drum Diva does not stop today, does he? Does he ever stop you guys?
No. Hey, Ford.
Yeah, seriously, like, if I could just...
Floating head right now,
just
right?
Just right here, please, Ford. Gentlemen, actually, while we're on it, take a moment and introduce yourselves. I know you've done it before, but we got a new audience tonight.
Oh, I'm Bobby.
I'm Jimbo.
Bo.
Hot.
Hot.
Yeah. If you had to pick a favorite thing from the last time you were on the show... I don't care what part of the night it was.
It was when William fed you a meat burrito.
Yeah.
We had...
Bobby.
For the audience, I'm a vegetarian. I'm like almost a decade-long vegetarian. And I'm pretty serious about it. And someone...
Sorry, Callie.
I was not expecting it. And I guess like the lines were crossed and I totally like took a bite and was like, oh, is there? And they literally, the person that was handing it was like, yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah, there's lots of meat in that.
Yeah.
And there was we definitely spit some.
I'm sorry.
Spit some food out.
We're
that's
still
all right.
Getting to know each other.
That's all right.
It's
usually not.
Food sucks.
It's usually not.
We have a motto. It's food sucks.
Wow, that's literally like the opposite of my motto. I just like eat all the food, just none of the meat.
Yeah, but isn't it such a hassle? I mean, you got to do it three times a day.
I usually knock it out like twice. I knock it out twice a day. I'll pull the.
You've got time day. For all that.
Yeah.
Right? God damn. Some people do nine small meals.
Oh man. Some people floss twice. Floss twice. What is that?
That's ridiculous.
That's entirely ridiculous. I eat twice. Gentlemen. Has anything like noteworthy occurred to you guys? Anyone's face or any within your life story since the last time we partied? besides...
Yeah, it was like a year. There's so much that's happened.
Has it been a year? I feel it's been like 7 months.
Well, I don't know. Ford, what was it?
Anything interesting? Have you guys done anything cool?
Gee whiz.
Willikers?
What was the coolest?
Where to begin?
Yeah.
Well, that...
We played on the moon. You didn't hear about it?
Wow, like the moon, like the moon of the Earth.
Well, the fake moon.
You know, where they filmed the moon landing in 1969?
Where everybody thinks there's a moon. Yeah.
So like a 1940s soundstage?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Somehow still intact? All that heroin across the border?
Mm-hmm. All right, so you're hairy mules?
That place is made of cheese. See, yeah. They got it wrong. The real moon is not made of cheese, but that place is
the
made
soundstage.
Of cheese. Right.
It looked the most like the moon.
Because it was...
Cheese.
It was the soundstage made of cheese.
You know how some...
That's how we came up with Food Sucks. It was all the cheese.
Yeah.
And you were like, oh, this is too much.
This sucks. Because I love cheese, and then we played on the moon, and it was so much cheese, and I was so conflicted.
Cheese OD.
You know? There's too much cheese, and then I was like... Sucks.
So I'm trying to be a professional right now, but like every time you guys say too much cheese, I want to punch you in the face because that doesn't exist.
I know.
Violence is not the answer.
I mean, says you.
Drugs are.
It's like absolute zero. Like, let's just know. Like, too much cheese and absolute zero are in the same category.
Fuck.
Man, you got into that, what is that, sodium nitrate that liquefies cheese?
Oh, yeah, mix it, you know.
I want three times that.
What does that word mean when the when the fat stays together?
I don't know. Anyone? Coagulation?
That sounds good.
Yeah.
Gentlemen, before I let you go from this fascinating interview, one last question, and I need you to take this one seriously for once in your lives. All right, Diva.
Mom.
What kind of sandwich do you think about while you're in the shower?
What is with the sandwich questions every time?
I like... Listen, I don't have to defend myself. Answer.
Oh, Monte Cristo, the most decadent of sandwiches.
That's a good shower sandwich. It's like steamy and hot. It's powdered sugar and it's deep fried.
What about you, Jim?
Mess you up. Mess.
My chef, dude, he loves a good Monte
like
Cristo.
A fancy Egg McMuffin.
What would make it fancy?
Oh, just, you know, bread that wasn't a week old or something.
All right. Like, you picked the right McDonald's today. Yeah. Egg McMuffin.
Keeping the standards nice and low.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean...
I appreciate that.
It's gonna suck no matter what.
Gonna frame your life.
You just gotta get in and get out.
Things that I dream about in the shower. Shitty McDonald's sandwiches.
Same question, or the same answer I always give. Is banh mi.
But what kind of banh mi? Is it like pork and pate?
Egg.
Just egg. A fried egg.
Yeah. And the rest of the ingredients that go on a banh mi.
Yeah, the jalapeno, carrots, cucumber, carrot, cilantro.
Pate.
Butter.
Pate.
That weird mayonnaise.
Duck liver.
God, that weird mayonnaise.
I want some right now.
You guys. All right, gentlemen, I'm going to resign you to go in search of your own banh mis in this moment.
Later.
Please bring me one tofu extra veggies. I like it spicy, if you hadn't caught on yet. You guys, I think we have a bumper queued up right now. I think we're going to head to a bumper.
Wait.
That was really fun.
And that raises all sorts of questions. Why couldn't it have been just...
Death deaths. We got Paper Piper.
Yes.
You remember when you were here? Tell us about it.
The last time I was here, I just, you know, I was complaining about the bathroom lines and how ridiculous they are.
And have you solved that problem yet?
Nope. Obviously, I'm still in my robe and...
You're still waiting for the bathroom?
Yeah, always.
Because the fortune teller's in there? Yeah.
You know what? That fortune teller, I gave her $40 and she just ran away.
She went to the restroom. She had to go real bad. You should have saw that coming.
God, and I had to wait behind her.
How'd that smell?
I wanted to eat it.
Well, I'll be the judge of that later. Whether it's edible. Let's... Well, Tom Waits?
Yes.
Wait a little longer. And remind me, you are...
Bobby.
Bobby! Mm-hmm. I don't think we're going to kill you, Bobby. We really like you around here.
Oh, thanks.
Well, I'll be the judge of that, though.
Oh, okay.
I'll be the judge of what I think.
What do you think?
I don't want to kill you.
Oh, thanks.
The fortune teller said that I would, but I'm going to prove her wrong.
That's really cool.
But Tom Waits.
Yes.
Wait a little longer.
Okay.
No, go ahead.
All right.
Tell us... You remember when you were here last time?
I do. I do indeed remember that.
Tell us about it.
Well, I would like to tell you about that, but...
I'm waiting.
I would like to tell you more about a fantastic cinematic discovery that I made. Now, I don't know if you're a fan of film. Are you a fan of film?
The art form?
The art form.
Yes.
Yes, we're talking about the same thing. Anyway, I want to make the argument here that Surf Ninjas is an underrated cinematic masterpiece. Are you familiar with Surf Ninjas?
I believe I saw the opening credits for that. Looked mm-hmm. like a garbage.
Starring Rob Schneider.
Looked like
now,
garbage, yes.
I don't know if you know this. This is a little known fact.
Rob Schneider?
Yeah.
Schneider?
It's a little known fact that in German, Schneider actually means sneaky one. So in a way you could say that Rob Schneider was
Rob Schneider, if you're watching, call in and defend yourself.
Rob Schneider was literally
born to be in the movie Surf Ninjas.
Defend yourself.
Is he in Wall Street?
Wolf
of Wall Street?
No.
Rob Schneider?
No.
Yeah. Is it Schneider or Schneider?
Rob Schneider. It seems almost predestined that he's in this movie.
And
this fact.
How long has he always surfed?
Fortunately.
Does he surf?
He's actually never
I'm sure that he does not actually surf.
But
he's very unathletic.
Eaten some surf and turf. Oh. So
Bobby, did you see that movie?
No.
What's your favorite movie, Bobby?
I like Felix the Cat.
That's a good one.
A ripoff of my my song Tommy the Cat that I performed with Primus.
Don't think that's true.
Primus?
I don't think that one's true.
You mean Primus?
I think it's absolutely true.
I know that. I think that you think that's
Tommy
true.
Tommy the Cat?
Tommy the Cat.
You did the vocals?
Of course I did the voice of Tommy the Cat.
No pun intended.
In his mind.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Tom Waits.
Yes.
Tom.
All right, what is this? Is this some sort of psychofraculator? I see. It's an old-fashioned revolver. Ah, yes.
But it's stuck. You see, it doesn't revolve.
No,
there's
no revolution. In fact,
wait,
this is more of
a really dangerous thing
to
play with. You should be really careful with that.
Please?
Tom Waits for no man.
Yeah. Well, neither
does. I really think that,
the fortune teller.
I could be. Oh!
You shot her!
Hey, that wasn't supposed to happen.
killed her!
Okay.
Well.
She's supposed to tell my fortune!
Why don't you go on and.
Go ahead and grab that $3.
Grab that from me and pass it on back down.
Okay.
No.
Well, who else is gonna die, though?
There you go.
Do you want paper pipe? Do you want to die?
We got someone else's fingerprints on it. The police will be confused.
Okay, no. since you don't know what the fortune's gonna be, go ahead and just kill yourself now. You can't do it with that. That's a fake gun, but... Try some other way. Oh, it worked.
Now let me put on my...
A fake death with a fake gun worked.
Put on my long-distance reading glasses here. So I can read the reactions of the fates as they see what complicated threads we weave here with our own doing.
I have a murder sign with you.
Tell us, what's going on with your love life, Tom?
My love life? Well, I've been married to my wife, Kathleen, for many years, and we're still writing songs together. We got, we've decided that it would be better if we moved out of our home and into a, what's the word for it? There's a... The indigenous peoples of America used to have this shelter that they could pack up and move about wherever. I can't remember the name of it, but we've decided to move into one of those.
Mm-hmm.
And since we have, our love life has never been hotter. Literally, is it because figuratively.
Is it because of the... There's no AC?
No, there's no AC. Alright, it's literally just canvas on sticks.
Just kill yourself, Tom. Bobby, kill Tom. Alright. You're gone. Oh, is it still not working?
I don't know!
I didn't see it revolve.
Me neither. It's hard to kill with a fake gun.
It really is. I don't know how the fortune teller died. I didn't see any bullets in there.
You know what I think is going on here?
Tell me, Bobby.
I think that there's some kind of magical...
Weren't you supposed to decide exactly who dies when?
I'm gonna decide that the music should start in here, and like right now. Let's go ahead and bring back Sleuth. That's my judgment.
Okay.
Them defensive. So hang on to your ego.
Hang on, but I know that you're gonna lose the fight.
They come on like they're peaceful, but inside they're so uptight. They drip through the day and waste all their thoughts at night. How can I come on when I know I'm guilty? So, hang on to your ego.
Hang on, but I know that you're gonna lose the fight.
Cause I'm an outsider, everything. Cause I'm an outsider, everything. I'm an outsider, everything. Everything you know, everything you know. It's a I'm an outsider of everything. Cause I'm an outsider of everything. Everything you know, is to me so. Everybody try to push me around. Everybody's trying to push me, you push me down. Everybody's trying to push me around. Everybody's trying to push me around. Cause I'm an outsider of everything. Cause I'm an outsider of everything. I'm an outsider of everything. Everything you know. Thank you. Oh,
okay. Woo!
All right, let's kill some more people. We got the couch here. Who's most likely gonna die? Because we're getting new furniture. We got Smokey and Bonafide.
Hey! Both ninjas!
Woohoo! What happened?
Smokey, how'd you see that movie? Well, Bonafide, this very interesting gentleman. Hold on. This very interesting gentleman told me that I should watch this movie. And, well, I did. And you did know you, what I mean? Did you? Was that interesting gentleman me? Because that's my favorite movie, Smokey! It is! I hope you never leave me. I hope you never do. I hope we're together forever. You know, Smokey?
Excuse me.
Oh, I was about to have a tender moment, but I'm sure there'll be many moments later forever, because that's how long we'll be together. I'm so sorry. Can I pet you, or?
That's fine.
Okay.
Can I
pet you, too?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's okay. All
right. Smokey, do you think we could make some money off petting couches?
Hey, I'll be a judge of that.
We could.
Yeah.
Okay, we can?
Yeah.
Well, that's lovely.
Yeah, I get 50% of the proceeds.
The proceeds, huh?
You get the change that falls into your cracks.
And then Bonafide over there gets another 50%, and me, Smokey,
I get 50% too.
You get the last 50%.
Yeah,
that's
together.
The best.
All
that's,
get 50%.
That's the best 50%, right, Couch?
The last 50%.
Yeah, that's a good one.
I don't think I agree with that.
Well, you're going to get the first 50, which is that's the leanest one.
All right, I can
the lean 50.
Well, I hope you wrote a will.
Well, why would we? We're going to survive. Everyone.
You're going to die.
Why? Everyone loves Smokey Bonafide. No. What are you doing?
Smokey's gonna die.
What are you doing? Why are you doing that to Smokey? Why? Smokey! No! No! No!
Smokey's been erased.
Smokey!
Hey, you're.
The couch is gonna die.
No!
Kill the couch, too! And we've got a house cat.
I'm not a cat.
What is this? Who is this?
You put that there.
Oh, no. Wait, who are you?
Me?
I'm dead.
I'm the new judge.
Oh, okay.
The old judge is dead.
You be the judge of that, then.
Yeah.
Give me that gun.
All right.
I don't want to live without my bona fide. I mean, Smokey. I never could get it right, damn it.
You're bona fide. You were always his bona fide. You know that.
I don't care who you are.
Hey, I'm the new judge.
But I'm gonna use you.
He killed your friend.
Yeah, but
he did.
What's it mean?
The sins of your fathers.
Well, I suppose... there's no point...
Yeah?
...keeping this crap up anymore. I don't have my partner.
I'll be the judge of that.
I kept you alive because you're the only one that knows what this is. Tell us again, bona fide.
Well, that's a piece of gadget we used to sell back on the rails. Looks like an innocuous camera if you look, but... interesting feature of this camera. You point it at the subject like so. So we got pretty Hollywood starlet, right? She wants her picture taken, ma'am. I don't know what your lighting is like. I'm not really going to take the picture yet because that's not what we're doing here. You see, no, well, careful. You don't want to accidentally squeeze this because what'll happen is she'll get sucked into the camera and she'll have to spend eternity with a guy named Mort sitting on his couch watching the world through a tiny pinwheel.
What's Mort like?
Well, Mort's kind of unpleasant. He's a guy we used to ride the rails with, but, we pinwheeled him.
When you say unpleasant, you mean...
he smells like a farted raccoon.
Yeah.
Like a real gross raccoon that just drank a bunch of milk and then farted.
That's neither here nor there. What is his... is he violent?
Well...
Was it smelly and silent?
It was smelly and silent, loud and proud, all over the place.
Does he like to hurt people?
Well, Mort's kind of... He's been sitting in this box for nigh on 60 years. He might be a tad unpredictable at this point.
Yeah.
Who built this?
Well, we don't know. We found it on the side of the road. It was... poor Mort was the one what found out what it does.
I think I might actually want to visit this Mort guy.
Well, Judge, you handle this. I got some errands to attend to related to this building. It's awful hot in here. It'd be a shame if something were to spark.
Yeah. Well, there's a lot of kindling. What do you think of that?
We could rekindle the Kindle and make it even hotter in here.
Okay.
Yeah, let's get this Mort guy. He sounds like a lot of fun.
All right.
Okay, maybe if I press the top button.
I don't know which one. I think it was that one.
That one makes you go in there. So if I hit this one, maybe he'll come out. And then we don't... there might be some explosion, but let's give it a shot. What do you think?
Do it.
All right, ready? One, two, three!
There's a ringing in my ear.
Yeah, I hear that.
I think it was because you just yelled in my ear, but...
No, that I can hear the ring. Does it sound like this?
Yes. Yeah.
I think we might just have died and gone to heaven.
Okay. Let's go.
All right.
If your chip pan catches fire, don't panic. Just follow these instructions. 1. Turn off the heat. 2. Run a cloth under a tap and wring it out. 3. Cover the pan and then wait until it's cooled right down. Don't try and move the pan, and whatever you do, don't throw water over the fire. The effects can be devastating.
5. Lots of kindling and electrical wiring. Maybe if I just tap it a little bit with my lighter, it'll all burn down and the whole world will know the vengeance of Bonafide. Gotta go.
Hey.
Hi, nice to meet you, Tom Waits. I'm a huge fan. Love it. I gotta run though. Goodbye.
That's one interesting fellow.
What's that smell?
Well, son, I think that there's a fire that's been kindled, not just in my heart and my loins, but also in this building.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm pretty sure we're all going to die.
I'll go down with that.
Yeah. I think it's about my time.
Yeah.
I always wondered what it would be like to be engulfed in flames. Not like from an artistic perspective, but like... from a masochistic, intense, worst pain you could ever feel sort of way. I mean...
Well, It's happening in Venezuela.
Oh, really?
People are being burned.
Should I go to Venezuela? I've never been.
Now's the time to go if you want to be engulfed in flames.
Oh.
They're doing it in the streets.
Wow. I think I might take you up on that.
Well, I'm not gonna go. I'm gonna stay here and die.
He meant novellas. That's
my historias.
What?
He said novellas.
Novellas, like,
my historias.
Your stories.
Si.
So, nothing's actually on fire? Is that what you're telling me?
Bien.
Okay. Well, that's actually kind of a disappointment.
But we can put things on fire.
Can we?
We can have some fire music, maybe.
All the people who wait in lines.
Which lines?
Which lines?
Bathroom lines.
Oh, man.
What's wrong with those people?
They just wait there. They don't move.
But...
do they have to go?
Is that their fault?
Yes.
Oh.
And we must burn them down.
To hell with them.
Hell with them.
Fire!
The flames have finally reached us.
The flames are here.
Fire. Oh, fire. I'm Tom. What are you doing? That is one sprightly, movable fire. And Oh my. There's an earthquake, and also this building is on fire.
I'm turning to ash.
This is remarkable.
And cold.
I'm melting. Oh, I'm fire.
Oh, there's a firequake inside this building. Don't know when it'll stop, but we will all die soon enough. If you write a novel, did I say that right? I lost it. Yeah, you write hundreds of songs. Not everyone's gonna be a winner. Say, fire.
What's up?
How you doing?
I'm pretty hot. How you doing?
Well, you're making me a little hot.
Good. Burn it down.
Say, baby, do you wanna get out of here?
Light my fire.
I feel like that's already been done.
Well then, yeah, let's go.
All right. So, you good burning in hell? Oh, she's already dead. Are you good burning in hell?
I'm good turning to coal.
I've changed my mind. I don't want to die here. I want to have a sordid affair with a living flame and then write a song about it.
Good.
Oh, there's a fire in my heart and also in my pants. Oh, I'm God is It was an earthquake. Oh my. Third degree of romance, let me tell you. Well, folks.
Go ahead and, before the whole place burns down, let's have Sleuth play one more time.
What are you think? You won't die!
And we're all dead.
I'm John Waits. I'm dead. Everyone in this building is dead. Except for Sleuth, because they're the only ones who thought to, brand their, thing. Alright. Well, I'm about to shuffle off this, mortally, coil here. Here I go.
Now everyone knows the vengeance is bona fide. All these characters are dead forever. They're never coming back. Ever. They are really for truly sure murdered. But you know who is coming back? Who will definitely come back? They're ready to go. They don't mind that everyone died. They love it. They love it so much. They're willing to play us out. Ladies and gentlemen, one more time, Sleuth!
We watched them all die.
side of the back door. We were boots to the rail yard. Spotlights burn into shattered glass. Future force field couldn't stand the fast.
Thanks.